What a shavuos. So Thursday night, as you know, I turn off my phone. I have nothing. I don't, no internet, not paying attention to anything that's happening outworldly. Didn't know that riots were going on. And all the way to Shabbos, all the way to Saturday night, and then you turn on your phone and what do you see? You see a whole bunch of white liberals. A bunch of white privileged liberals tearing up the cities, tearing up the country, tearing up, and it's happening in all liberal-run cities, you know. It's amazing. It's amazing to where today this world is coming to, and look at your future. Like, Antifa, Black Lives Matters, they're putting bricks out in the middle of the corners to start to entice it. You see videos of people paying people to protest. You hear this coming out, and people, conspiracy. Wow, talk about conspiracy. The Bernie bros are at work right now. The Democrats are big time doing it. Because if it was riots from the Trump side, because the people that are out there actually that care for America were the ones, and I commend those. I commend those people that were protecting their neighborhoods. They were sticking up for their businesses. Like, you really, really got basement white privileged liberals enticing attacks. Starting riots, throwing Molotov cocktails at police officers in urban areas, in black neighborhoods, in Jewish neighborhoods. They destroyed L.A. They destroyed L.A. It's ridiculous. Manhattan, I mean, listen, I commend those people that were holding it down, holding that line down. Those black people that were holding the line down at Target over here next to the Barclays Center, amazing. Amazing. Good job. Good job, and I hope every community sticks up for their community. This isn't the way to protest for somebody getting killed. This isn't the way you honor George Floyd. This isn't what you do. It's ridiculous. It gets to this point where, wow, how evil and how demented and how nasty people can really be. How spoiled these American kids are that are voting for communism, that want communism, that are looking for the socialism. I mean, seriously. Trump, good thing for calling these people out as terrorists. They're declared terrorists right now, this Antifa mob. And they're a bunch of basement punks. These are losers, like punks, like straight up punks that sit on the internet all day and make ridiculous comments. And these are the guys that are like straight up working to destroy America, to destroy everything that our veterans, our forefathers fought for. I'm a proud first generation American. My mom ran away from communism. She ran away from the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union turned around and everybody broke off. It became somewhat of a democracy, but still, what's going on over here in America, never before would you imagine this, but there are the good people. There is still hope for America, a lot of hope. And a lot of these people just love America. The patriots, the black Americans that own their businesses, that are fighting for their businesses. The Jews that are owning businesses, that are fighting for their businesses. The regular Americans that are fighting for their businesses. People that want to open up, people that are starving. When you got people doing nothing, and you're offering them $200 to go protest, yeah, they're going to go out there and take the money, especially when they have nothing to do in their lives. Especially when you've been thugging your whole life. Like right now, it's like the best play for anybody that's chilling out, doing nothing, and is willing to commit criminal acts to go loot. Obviously, and especially it's the best excuse. A lot of people aren't getting arrested. I big it up to those police officers that are marching and keeping those protests peacefully, because you're marching peacefully in protest. That's fine. But this looting nonsense, this is all a plot, all a deploy, and I hear they're bussing people into the cities. It's crazy. It's crazy. World, wake up. Wake up, because these demon rats, horrible, dangerous people. They're so dangerous to our society that it's like, it's crazy. And if you don't have the right people to have in Congress, to have in public office, to have as mayors, to have as governors, to have as a president, to have a senator, if we don't have the right people in office, we're America. I'm just telling you. I know a guy that works for a Democrat congresswoman, and he's scared to death. He says, if we're not voting for Trump, if Trump doesn't win, we're all screwed. And here's the plan. This is how they do it. This COVID-19 thing and now this rioting thing, everything. Everything that they do is for the destruction and divinity of America. But united we stand. United we stand, and we're not going to fall. We're going to keep standing. And I see so many patriots, so many woke people. Thank God. Thank God. So many people left the party. Like I said, I never cared for politics until our lives became in danger. Until our lives became in danger. And right now you see the danger. Conspiracy theory. You liberals are nuts. I'm sorry to tell you, but it's just like, it's a fact. It's a fact. If you're going with everything that you see that these liberal Democrats are doing, while the rest of the country is trying to build and trying to grow, and even the way they speak, even the way they're always speaking about the poor, oh, feel bad for this, feel bad for that. Yeah, the poor, but they're teaching you the fact that you can grow, that you can grow. Why are you always putting people down? Why don't you pick them up? Why don't you help them grow? Bring leadership into their communities. Help them earn their businesses. Help them grow a business. Start up places where you can teach these people businesses instead of always giving free stuff away and keeping them under control and in poverty. Wake up!